Hey guys, and welcome to the second part of Bioshock Infinite. Now we actually get to enjoy more of the gameplay elements, including this.
By killing a cop, okay.
So it's a good setup.
I hear Grand Theft Auto 5 came out.
Oh yeah, that. Pretty cool. Cool stuff. So at this point, there's actually a lot of points that can be interacted in this level, including let's just go to Monument Island. Nope. Well, the area we need to go gets blocked off here, so let's just fight these cops off again, because that's fun. Sorry, your hat. This dude has a pistol, so I'm just going to sneak behind him.
And by sneak behind him, you mean walk directly in front of him?
I'm stealthy, shut up. But now I have my pistol. Plus, it's a golden pistol because my whole season pass deals, so enjoy it, it's pretty.
Neat.
So, as you see, things are starting to devolve here in this beautiful city. This is the guy that we were talking to that was wanting me to throw the baseball at the interracial couple here. For controlling these particular voxophone situations, you can not only just play it as that point, but you can always replay them anytime you want. And if you press down on the direction pad, it'll actually start playing the most recent one you picked up again. Just in case you want to hear this stuff again. Some of it's plot relevant.
I think was the guy doing the baseball thing?
Yes. He looks a lot like his other people, but that was Jeremiah Fink. Right now, since I have enough money, I'm going to spend more money to boost my abilities with possession. Because currently, possession really only works on machines, but now it actually works on enemies.
Now turns machine and man into allies.
As this says right here.
Hold and release to create a ghostly trap.
Plus, it also shows another element of the vigors. If you hold down the trigger, you can create different abilities with the vigors, specifically traps. They're like mines. Personally, I never really used them that much because they do use a lot of your salts. But depending on how strategy you set those for, it's a good defensive measure. But this is also a good defensive measure, too. This is a turret doing my job for me.
Yeah, personally, I can't think of if any traps were especially useful for me. I use them a lot, but yeah, it does take up a lot of salts.
Sometimes it's better to directly fire them. And there's not many situations where defensively you'll find yourself in. Ow. I win.
Travis.
I'm okay. You know what? I feel like celebrating my victory right now for beating all those guys, so fireworks show. Fireworks show.
Man, so I punched a turret and I won.
No one knows where I am. Woo!
Yeah, not giving away my position.
So in this game, it's very hard to aim unless you do the main focused aim right there. So the quicker you learn that, the better you can headshot people and take them out quick. Oh, hi.
Oh.
You're mine now.
Well, 23 skidoo, my friend.
Well, possession only works for a short period of time. And one of the cool things about possession is right afterwards, they do this. Ow, my face. Ow, my face. Ow, my face! Okay. So, the whole stipulation of how they say it is the enemies feel so guilty for their actions while possessed they kill themselves. Which is weird, because that guy did absolutely nothing. But either way.
Kind of loses its drama when you just beat yourself in the face with a baseball bat.
Ain't that the bee's knees?
You wonder why enemies are jumping out of the skies. Those sky hooks are things they're swinging down on to get in my areas. It definitely gives you a convenient... Oh, thanks. it gives me a decent excuse for enemies just dropping in or randomly spawning. Right now, my health is pretty low, but luckily a lot of health items because of this damn turret holding me down. They made it very nice by making the turrets very noticeable because they have those big red lights on them. And they're honestly not that tough. They do cut down your health pretty quickly, especially at this point of the game. Luckily, I do have a lot of ammo here. Sneaky!
The red lights and green lights signifying allies and enemies is a carryover from the first Bioshocks.
Yep, there were more of the security-based guard cameras that were doing it. And in the same way, you could, instead of possessing them with a vigor or with a ability like that, you could hack into them and make them your allies. And there was a number of different kind of turret controls for that. This guy sucks, so bye, head.
Jesus.
This game's violent, but yeah, there's that.
Really? You're going around, walking around with a gun. I think I got the picture.
Also, these cops kind of suck. Plus, I'm a good shot.
That guy kind of tripped. I love that.
See, I'm one shot killing these guys. They aren't too tough.
Take cover, crap.
Coffee is a good source for salts beyond actually having salts. Ooh, fruit stand. That means some healing. I'm gonna eat all of it. Oh, I can't eat any of it. Okay. But hey, money.
Okay, so we can't steal fruit, but we can steal directly from the cash register.
Well, sometimes we can steal fruit. That's the weird part. You'll just find one piece of fruit, you can pick up the rest. Nope.
Booker's like, no, not today.
I'm mean, but not that mean.
I mean, I only shot a bunch of cops and punched a turret to death.
So at this point, they keep on mentioning, bring the firemen over. And I'm like, what the hell's that? Anyway, I'm sure that's not relevant. Let's keep going.
It's getting hot. What's going on?
It's me.
Yeah, that's a cool-ass gate. I hope it doesn't reveal anything. Oh.
Oh, man. You're almost dead already.
What are you hitting? He never went down that easy for me.
Oh,
it's because your fucking gun.
Oh, yeah, the golden gun does hit a little bit harder. But now I get a new vigor. I'm just going to drink out of this naked demon's head. And it causes spontaneous human combustion.
All right, and that was Bioshock Infinite. Thanks for pulling everybody. It was a great Let's Play.
And that's how my story ends. I'd have been pissed if that was the case. Whoops. So this is the...
Were the delays worth it, Travis?
Back to our tutorial manager.
Hold and release to create an explosive trap.
I got the devils like, oh, circumstances. I accidentally pressed down on the trackpad to Jeremiah Fink is going to tell me more about racism. Plus, so now I can fire off, kind of lob a fiery grenade as the fireman was doing. Or I can set up an explosive trap! But I'm, honestly, out of a lot of the vigors here, I don't use this one as much. I might try this Let's Play if people encourage me to, but it's not one of my favorites.
Yeah, I never got a lot of use out of Devil's Kiss.
Maybe, well, in the original Bioshock, you did have just kind of like a fire flamethrower out of your hand. This one bounces around a lot, which can be good and bad. But I'm just going to possess that. Because I'm just going to assume here that if there's a turret here, there's going to be more than that. So do my job for me! So people are dying before they even get to the gate. This guy somehow made it through all of it. He's like, yeah, I'm going to win. Not at all. And they did my job for me. That's one nice thing about that. Ooh, see, there's a slick, fiery spot right there. I hit it with the fireball. I can make it burst into flames. No, it just kills them, so I don't really get to use it. That's a good idea. Put it in your fireworks that explode faster. So, salts. At this point, I have kind of a quick it's hard to say quick equip of two different kinds of vigors. You can set these as different kind of vigors as you go later in the games when you start getting more of them. So that way you can pick like your two favorites that you can switch to pretty quickly. Otherwise, you have to open up a wheel to be able to do that. But for now, just robbing all these people. Somehow he had coffee in his pocket. But time to go eat some dinner because I'm fucking starving, man. This pig door. Now, these are always good breather moments just to kind of give you an idea of how, you know, Booker's thoughts in a very quick quip here. This is also going to be a big part for me because, as I mentioned, this is going to be my big clump of Season Pass material. If you don't have the Season Pass, some of the stuff you don't have access to. Nothing that would be majorly for story purposes, but they are little boosts that definitely help you at the beginning of the game. But first, I feel like leaving. No. I feel like, you know, anytime I play these games, if there's a corner to look, I'm going to look through every drawer, find one I have, or drink all the alcohol and get really drunk.
Hey, at least you healed up.
Alcohol has an effect of healing you, but it does knock down your salts. Salts just kind of, I imagine, is brain power, so you lose some of your brain power when you're drunk. Hoi hoi. Found some machine gun ammunition, just hints of your next weapon here. So that's why it's mentioned the golden machine gun as well. These things are pretty cool. They're also like the Voxophones. Back in the day, these were called Nickelodeons. They would have little movies you could watch through these screens, and each one of them give you a little bit of an insight on the city of Columbia. There's also an achievement for finding all of them. But they are the screaming propaganda film, which is fun.
By the way, speaking of the loading screens, I like how their very first caption you see is a note from Booker about his current place in the mission.
Right. That's just in case, I imagine, if you end up closing the game and trying to start from that point, you'll at least have some idea where you were before.
So I think there are multiple things that he could say in that situation. Because you do end up going to certain places multiple times.
So what this story is telling about is kind of the beginning of Columbia itself. Columbia was basically just a big city created by the U.S. government, but the people there eventually acted upon their patriotism and killed a bunch of Chinese civilians. So at this point, they said, you know, if the government is going to talk down about us about doing those sorts of things, well, screw it, we're going to secede. So that's why Columbia is just kind of floating around on its own. It's like its own little country here. But basically, they're more America than America, as they're saying for themselves. See those cowardly Americans. No thanks, says the prophet. We're fine on our own. Finn! I find it ironic that it's like America, but they have like Finn, like in French. But see, there's a lot of things sitting around here that is only accessible to season pass owners. Why are you following me? Also, hey, it's those people that we saw before. Or hearing, basically, while I'm drinking and eating their food.
With a gun out, no less.
What you're seeing right here on those little boxes are actually clothing. You can actually wear different levels of clothing that give you certain abilities. In this case, if I could take this hat, it gives my my Skyhook an electric shock effect. I'm on most times when I hit with it. As you go around the game, you'll find new clothes that give you different special bonuses, and you can switch and pick what kind of buffs you want for your character. Some of them will boost your ability to use special powers. Some give you better strength when you're riding on the Skyhooks. Just depends on how you play. Like this one, for example, I really like because it gives you a higher capacity for ammunition. The big bottles are kind of like your heart pieces in Legend of Zelda. By drinking these, they'll give you certain boosts to your health, to salts for abilities like that, and one that's called Shield, which we'll see what that means here in a bit. When I do this, you can kind of pick and choose the way you want to do it. I like to try to keep these things very even keel, so I'm going to take my time and drink these and boost just every little thing about it. Shields, which is the next thing I'm adding, is something that we haven't gotten yet, but we're about to get here in a second. It's basically our ability to take less damage when we're hit, so we're less likely to be killed like we were at the beginning. Like most first-person shooters, it will regain itself after a period of not being shot, and we'll definitely need it because the enemies will get tougher from here. You'll find that handy in a pinch. So at this point is when we're supposed to get it, but I got it way ahead of time, but thanks, lady.
Surprising that it worked.
Surprising that it didn't kill him.
But a magnetic repulsive field around one's
body. I love these characters, by the way.
Yeah.
Shoot him. Shoot him. Damn it.
How dare you?
If you try to shoot at them, you will miss every shot, and they'll comment on it.
Father Comstock called on me today.
Hey, the more you know. Well, anyway.
The man pays for exactly 100
I'm just, if you notice, I have a habit of just taking everything. That's one of the biggest points I make in this game. Just take as much health and items and things you have, even if you don't have it, because you never know when you can need the money from it or the health boost. So just eat everything, take everything, be a glutton.
And if you're worried about cigarettes or alcohol being in containers, they're purposely made not to show up, so you only see them out sitting around.
Now, you can't pick and choose specifically what to take. I just have a habit of just mashing the button, which takes everything.
Yeah.
Because, again, I'm a glutton. This is also introducing another benefit to us. The Skyhook is not just only a weapon, but when you have that reticle pop up like that... Yay!
Damn,
I'm Spider-Man.
Oh, it's a magnet, okay.
But that's how it ends up clipping onto these things. So for now, it's letting us jump from hook to hook, which is kind of physically impossible, but whatever.
Yeah, I was about to say, why did he just fly all the way over?
So not only does it find itself pretty useful as a vantage situation, also moving around the city, but in this situation, you can do a super uppercut!
Oh, God!
And now I managed to get the machine gun, or I should say the golden machine gun! I'm sorry.
Oh, Travis. Oh, God.
You're breaking the game.
Don't go breaking my game.
You piece of shit.
So I, my personal strategy for especially these early parts of the game is to use possession as much as possible. I'll enter the battle first, trying to possess at least one enemy, and then begin firing. So that way I have an ally on my side at the very beginning. Like this. Not only does he distract, but he does sometimes take out an enemy or two. So I'm just waiting back here, just waiting for shit to get done. So yeah, a lot of people died, and I just made it back up here. There's unfortunately a turret over here, so I gotta move pretty quick. But here's a fireball for you. So yeah, machine guns are obnoxious. Well, that's kind of a waste of ammunition.
Yeah.
Luckily, the enemies are a lot easier to kill than the turrets, but oh well. Time to make cover!
Yeah, I never found the machine gun especially effective.
This one hits a little bit harder, but I found my pistol to be a lot more effective. But either way, since I have a lot of ammunition with this thing, might as well use it. This machine gun's still rather annoying. See, the fireball really doesn't do much. He uses a lot less salt than possession, but still. This guy's in an awkward position. It's just really weird to think that they have food and coffee in their pockets. Cups of coffee at that.
Without little tops or anything, it's just a cup of coffee.
With the saucer.
Right, it doesn't even tip over.
What I find interesting is some of these characters, like that woman right there, is wearing like a Statue of Liberty head. See, she took down a guy. The possession's a really useful ability. Unfortunately, out of most every ability in the game, it uses the most salts. So that's why it's always good to go hunting around, because I'll usually run out of salts pretty quick if I use that effectively. But this early area isn't too difficult. Just taking cover when you need to, and using, just testing out your vigors is always a good moment in this game. That guy's aim was awful, by the way. Plus, the machine guns have a pretty awful recoil. And that's a really cool effect. You can shoot it long enough. Oh! There's my shocker punch. He's bones now.
And dirt.
Yep. Nice thing about that shocker punch, for most enemies, it's an insta-kill. So, nice cool ability. Plus, it stuns a lot of enemies, too. Different enemies you fight will have different weaknesses to different vigors and possessions. Some will be weaker to electricity, some won't have any effect of fire, that sort of thing. So, I possessed the last enemy in this part of the level. That's why the music stopped. But hey, I get to see another way these guys take themselves out. Hey, Statue of Liberty, let's hang out. We can be friends forever. Ah, oh god. He dropped all of his arm pads, oh no. I'm like, hey, I wonder what's going on here. Shit, I'm sorry. So, when you find other bottles of vigor the same type, it doesn't give you, like, double versions of that. They're just, really big salts, basically. I kind of wish you could just do upgrades where it's just like double fireballs or whatever, but these areas of the game are not really plot relevant, but they're areas where you can usually find side missions or extra equipment you can't usually find. I have allergies.
Just imagine you're slowly melting.
But yeah, these areas right here, you can find a lot of different items. Specifically for this area, there's a chest in one of these rooms. Not a woman's chest, but a treasure chest. That when you check for it, a lot of times will be locked with a key. We'll see here in a minute. It's actually in this bedroom. Very distinct. Can't open it at the moment. But luckily, thanks for the prompt telling me they can't open it, because I just did. So at this point, I need to try to find some kind of key to unlock it. So sometimes that means if I end up going forward in the game and finding a key, it's good to go back and find these chests again, because usually there's something really valuable in them. And I know for sure. Hence this guy named Brian Codswold. I love Codswold as a last name. Look at that mustache.
Such an old-timey name.
We're going to the Codswolds! For brunch! So more Spider-Man fun. So at this point, it's really weird to think that I'm holding a machine gun with one hand while twisting my arm around to aim. Booker's very flexible. And I played it again just because I want you guys to hear it, and it wasn't an accident. I mean, I wouldn't, of course, do anything on accident.
There's a really key word that he says that's going to pop up later on in the storyline.
Plus, listen, I mean, I do enjoy listening to things, but a lot of times the writing in these Voxophone messages are just great. But, oh well. I like this idea that all these things are sitting out here, because a lot of it gives that impression that people just walked out of what they were doing. You basically caught them with their pants down. That's why there's, like, money sitting on the table and food. And I like this push, too. There's also, although it seems like a lot of these people in this city are haters, here's some slave and sympathizers here. You can find right here a bunch of printing presses for propaganda and stuff like that. Oh! Hello! The one they're after. And sometimes, you know, as I said, they've said at a point in the game, not all people are here out to kill you. I'm ready to fight them, but they won't let me. So, at this point, these nice people are going to let me into their house. See, there's people, there's runaway slaves in here that they're helping. So, it's good to have this kind of element that says, you know, hey, there's real life going around in this city. And there's things to interact with, just interact with. Of course, you can flush toilets and turn on sinks and stuff like that. But I'm just going to rob them. They let me into their home. I think that's kind of racist thing to do.
We're family at this point.
We are family. I'm gonna steal all of your shit.
And your cigarettes.
And your cigarettes?
Yep.
Yeah.
So, Who's there? That's who's there. Nice little carnival area. They obviously, again, caught with their pants down. There's all these festivities going around, but not anymore. Those little firework sounds are basically them sending out little fireworks to show my location, which I've put effort to do myself, actually.
I thought that was like a rocket launcher.
Nope, those are little sounds just to let people know where you are. Not that it makes a difference, because it only usually sends maybe two or three more people at you. Or and a fireman, shit. So firemen are kind of kamikaze style, as I saw earlier. Their fireballs are really obnoxious, but it's really obnoxious when there's those oil slicks around because their fire spreads pretty quick. Plus the turret being on that side, yeah, it's kind of annoying. But eventually when they take enough damage, they'll charge at you and explode, just kind of kamikaze style, but they're too tough. See, at this point, yeah, there it goes. So it's my best bet just to hang out here and just let my shields come back. But as you see, my health is still down, so I don't gain health back. The shield can build, though. I mean, I can gain health up by eating and stuff, since there's food absolutely everywhere. And listen to all this propaganda over the radio, just saying, oh, this shitty person's killing children and all this kind of stuff like that. Oh, and this person right here that did this little display, not this picnic, but this whole Wild West display is like my favorite person in this game. And this next Voxophone still cracks me up every time I hear it. So I'll be quiet for this.
Gobstock came by the wagon at dawn. Man was just transfixed by my trophy scalps. Asked about the white ones there. I said, well, sir, if your quarry dwells in the jungle and beds down with the local color, why split hairs? Not a chuckle out of him. Either he ain't seen a man go native, or maybe too many. Anyhow, now it's got me hunting down this Daisy Fitzroy. Hope you don't expect me to stuff and mount her. Yeah.
It's the most awkward thing ever. Yeah. I love that one. So yeah, that's just another dude in this town that wants to stuff and mount Daisy Fitzroy. So we're entering a very creepy place. Oh, hello, Illuminati. So this is pretty much the religion of the crows. Look at this picture. This is Comstock fighting the Serpents of the Nations, and the Serpents of the Nation is a Jewish guy. A black guy, and I think a Chinese guy?
Yeah.
All in the heads of the dragon. So it's all, like, him fighting all the races. Because this guy has a white superiority complex that, like, you wouldn't believe. And this is kind of a shrine to everything. It's disgusting, and yeah, those pictures right there, those are that's John Wilkes Booth. There's a statue to John Wilkes Booth, the guy that shot Lincoln. They think he's awesome. If you look around, we'll have an opportunity to look here. Like that painting on the wall right there, for example. It's a big painting of John Wilkes Booth shooting Abraham Lincoln. But if you look at Abraham Lincoln, he got a big set of devil horns on him. They kind of hate that guy.
Because he freed the slaves, right? And they're like that.
Yep. And you'll hear their reasoning behind it. It's that kind of propaganda-based solidified reasoning that's ridiculous. I'll let those guys fight each other, though. It's fine. If you notice, it's retracting the pistol because the pistol is working out better for me right now.
Yeah.
Yep. That guy was really confused for a second. Shot himself in the face. This area's really disgusting. If you look around, there's just rotting food everywhere and bird shit, and it's...
The food is apparently supposed to be for the crows.
Yep.
But I read a really interesting piece about this somewhere. It's kind of an interesting point that although this little mini religion is made to worship crows, they still give them human food because they're so transfixed in their own way of thinking, they can't think of anywhere like any other way of thinking else. So they think like a crow would act how they would act.
Here's some more of that propaganda bit. I could also think of the kind of relation to things like Jim Crow laws, if you want to get more literal with it. And it's kind of ironic that they pick the crow just because of it being a black bird.
Yeah.
But hey. See, the way they view Abraham Lincoln is that he was kind of the instigator of the Civil War and not someone who saved people. So that's why they see him as the kind of evil devil that he was. But keeping that in mind, this is supposed to be this perfect, nice little religion. These people are kind of nuts. Oh, hi, J-Willow4.
Has he been in every LP you've done so far?
Nearly. At least someone has. This dude right here sitting is kind of creepy. You can hear his voice kind of fading in and out. We might have to fight him later. We'll see. So we can, there's choices we can do here, because there's a number of guys down there. I could just jump down there, guns blazing, or I could try to sneak to them, or try to go from the top or the bottom row. Really up to me. Oh, thanks for telling me how to stand up.
In case you forgot.
So this is going to get super chaotic, guys, just fair warning. First, I'm just like, hey, you know what? Every action movie starts with a grenade, hoi! These guys aren't smart. SMRT. But there's a lot of them. Shit. shit. Oh, electric punch. So I don't know what's exactly going on right now, but I'm winning. And he's gone. And he dropped a box. He melted into a box.
I thought that's super weird how when an enemy fades away, they just leave behind a log box.
Yeah. Kind of immersion lost a little bit, but hey. That guy's, what the hell, get on my face. These guys kind of suck. But the guy with the crows around him kind of disappeared on us. He ran behind the back door, but to not explore this area would be stupid. So that's what I'm going to do. More recordings of more of his racist rhetoric here. Listen to this. Look at that picture. It's a picture of all the races, at least all the minority races, surrounding Abraham Lincoln with fire. Pretty strong opinions they have. But yay, more shield. But hey, we found the key for the chest back there. So I can either proceed forward, or being the person I am, I'm going back to get that chest.
I would hope so.
I wouldn't talk about it unless I did. See, here's the fucked up reasoning of these people is that they see themselves, because they're being white, that it's a burden for them to have to do real jobs. And that black people just don't have... They should be thankful that they don't have the rights that white people do, because white people's rights are a burden. And that's such a fucked up way of thinking. That you're just like, oh, I can't wait to kick your ass. Like that.
And that.
And that. hell like that guy's like, point a gun, whoa! How did it hit him? I think he was even surprised by that.
I like how the only reason he got hit by the fire is because he turned around like an idiot.
So yeah, I'm one-shotting people like crazy right now. This pistol's pretty awesome.
Really? Was there any challenge before?
Yeah, these little enemies are kind of puny. But hey, it's a good opportunity. Hey, look, that guy isn't green. I haven't taken money from you yet. Thank you. Also doing the position on him, if I remember correctly, also gives you a discount. I don't like using doors. Aw, I broke your window, but I can't go through here, but sorry. Thanks, people who saved me. I just broke your stuff and stole your stuff, too. But hey, they're gone. I like when you keep a vigor long enough that you see your right hand kind of show the effects of it, like that had that little woman floating around your hand. If you do the fire one, you kind of see the hand glowing with flames. But luckily the house in this situation to go back for the chest isn't far, especially with super jumps like that. So we better hope by this point of having to run all the way back to fight these enemies that what's in the chest is worth it. Oh good. It sorta is.
Okay.
Yeah, don't worry about it. Just what the doctor ordered. Good thing is any kind of boost like that is going to help you later in the game. The more you find, the better. So that was worth it. Now, if I went in there, it was just like a $100 bill, I'd be like, ugh. So I can kill enough people to get that. Which is such a weird thing to say. If you look at their flags, too, it's interesting. It's an American flag with the stripes, but it has one star in the very center representing Colombia. But it still has that American look to it, so it's almost like they want it to be America, but they're still not willing to lose the patriotic look at the flag, but still made it different. What I find interesting about this area is that it's surrounded by this big spooky mist just here.
Yeah.
Ooh.
I can't see you.
This does remind me a bit of some kind of super like Illuminati-esque cult. And it's interesting because the way I view these group of people, it is kind of like I envision it as the radicals of this particular big religious sect that worships Comstock. But Comstock speaks on their behalf, but they represent a certain facet of the religion.
That every religion has, of course.
Oh, of course. But these people definitely follow the rule of being super extreme in their beliefs, even to the point of violence. Listen to this radio conference, too. Full of wrath and bent on harm, the anarchist maliciously wounded several Colombian peacemakers. Yeah, remember when I hurt those civilians? Yeah, radio. You're right on the ball, aren't you? But yeah, I'm a bad guy, apparently. Sorry, Yoshi. So now we're on pursuit of a certain crow-surrounded individual. To me, I think he's leading the sect. He might just be one of the acolytes, I should say. To me, a lot of the eye symbols kind of represent that Illuminati feel, because I think the symbol for the Illuminati is the eye. That's a reference to the original Bioshock. Actually, Kevin Levine voiced that in the original Bioshock, the creator, or at least the main director for this little series, so that's kind of a reference to the very first game, or at least the very first Bioshock. So, this kind of shows a little bit more on the foundations of this religion itself. The religion itself is supposed to carry on the burdens of the death of Comstock's wife, which has been kind of mentioned lightly in this game. We don't know why she died, but she is dead. And they see themselves being carried by a burden of it. But so, this first cell is the guy we're chasing right now. Oh, hey, very obvious thing being hidden.
So that we might cover the city with eyes. You gotta love stuff like that, especially in cartoons where you know exactly what item the character's gonna touch because it's shaded differently.
What I like about it is that it's really obviously hidden, but there's blood streaks and stuff, so it shows kind of the paper-thin hiding elements of the brutality of this particular sect. But these are fire pants.
Yeah, I was just about to say.
Or I can wear have ghost soldier pants. I'm thinking fire pants. Yeah, fire pants. They kind of burn when you wear them.
Who wouldn't want fire pants? I mean, if somebody calls you a liar, you're like, fucking, I know.
who's got third degree burns under his crotch. Fire pans.
Pizza Joe.
Pizza Joe. Burn before is cool, but this is... I hear the guy in here. Here, I'm here to help you. Oh. This guy is so cruel that he had time to punish a guy while I was coming to him.
I thought he was going to close the door and be like, yeah, no. Well, that was silly.
I like this added music going on right now, but this guy can teleport, so I'm a little... This part always kind of... First, when I played it, it made me very hesitant. And this is an opportunity that's telling me to try to use traps. I'm like, oh, I guess. I don't really use them at all, but if this guy game says I should... So you hold down the trigger button, and when you find a spot to lay it, there it goes. As soon as he goes in proximity, it blows up. He's somewhere around here. He's back here? Oh, there he is. Oh, shit. So this trap isn't working. Traps aren't working. Huh. Walk through that guy. Ow. Okay, that didn't really work. This is why traps suck. This is why traps suck. Normal fire seems to work a lot better. But when he does teleport, the flames go off. Luckily for this guy, he's a close-range guy, but he does a lot of damage when he gets close. And I don't exactly have the good weapons or vigors to fight this dude. So I'm just gonna shoot spontaneously. But hey, we found a new vigor.
What's this? Some new kind of vigor?
And guess what it does?
It's a hell of a thing.
Make it talk to crows?
Caw-caw, caw-caw, Dumbo.
So I was close.
5 minutes.
Hip hip clop, clop clop clip, yummy.
Jimmy, no, come back.
So we get to hear another voice for that. Oh no, crows, haha. I love the idea of using magic power to summon a nest. Here's some babies.
And now birds.
So this one I didn't really use much when I originally played through it, but I'm going to make a point to use it more. Because it is kind of awesome. This is kind of taking room for the bug swarm move that you got in Bioshock, which is very similar to it, where you're able to shoot out bees.
But you're shooting out crows, so it's more awesome.
Yeah, of course. Of course, you know, shooting bees at your arm is kind of cool. It's like that hound that shoots bees at you in Mr. Burns' house. Simpsons reference, look it up. We're going to go further from here now that we have this special power. But that, I mean, at this point, we've pretty much played up to the point of getting some special powers. Here's some more clothes. And there's a little reference to Bioshock 1. So now I can pick between Electric Punch or Fire Punch. They have different effects, so I'm trying to decide which one I like better. Let's go for Fire Punch. But hey, look, a monkey wrench. It's a reference to Bioshock 1, the very first weapon you pick up in the game. Yeah, next time, we're going to go farther into actually getting closer to Elizabeth and saving her. Trying to get to Monument Island and all. So, I'm mad he talked there, because that was either actually a funny conversation where it's like, he could have an eye patch and be 4'6".
God forbid!
You see that one midget's like, oh darn! They got me again!
We will be doomed if he has any of those items.
But yeah, one thing always kind of what I liked about this game is that it didn't take a lot of... It's not taking any pop shots into any particular religion, as we've mentioned. There could be a lot of areas where you can see the effects of Christianity to that, but it's... I think it's more of a statement on religions going haywire themselves, maybe to the organization of them. But it feels more like a cult. And everyone thinks cults are wrong, so fuck cults.
Yeah, what I'm noticing about this more than anything is that it's taken a lot of the Christian imagery and just supplanted the Founding Fathers into it instead.
It gives the idea, well, I mean, it makes a lot of sense because you have someone like Comstock who basically got baptized and saved. So his fundamental of what Christianity is was probably good, but then it got bastardized the longer he, you know, was in that position, had more power, and it became this what it is now, where it wasn't just people worshiping God, now people are worshiping him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what I love about a lot of religions, where if anyone is named a prophet, chances are they're not going to say that they're the Messiah, but they're still going to have everyone kill each other over them.
But yeah, we're going to see a lot more situations of kind of the internal networkings of this particular city, how it works. And also, it just kind of makes you hate the citizens more you play this game. Plus, we get to hear more of the hold to release to create an explosive trap that I'll never do.
Wait,
I love how they just... It's so, like, dangerous and reality-filled, but then they show these little devils like, oh, no! Just imagine some figure for just the Let's Play. Press this button and enjoy the humor and random spontaneous comedy of the Straw Hat No. Hold a release to create a awesome and hilarious trap.
May cause gonorrhea.
Now kazoo.
It's not calibrated. There.
That's calibrated?
I have to be forceful with it. By which I mean I scream into it.
Now including extra harmonica.
Now gonna skyhook your mother up a flight of stairs.
I'm playing it so wrong.
Let's just create the shittiest band ever.
Get
synthesize a harmonica and tuba mouthpiece.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
Booker murdering people with skyhooks. Daisy Fitchell, I'm gonna stuff her. Yeah.
I used to be able to do the choo-choo thing.
You have a train? One of those little trains?
No, it's a technique on the harmonica where you could just make the sound of a train chugging.
Like this?
Yeah, there you go.
Ah, close now.
I don't remember how to do it. It's been a long time.
Hold to release to sing One Hit Wonders. It's kind of... Is it kind of perfect that happened at the exact same time?
It's Bioshock Infinite, everybody.
Hold a release to take your prom date to the junior prom. I just want to create a meme now of just hold and release to have effects. Hold a release to swallow an entire giraffe. You guys are the shittiest band ever.
Fuck you, tuba mouthpiece.
If my wish was good, whatever.
Fucking all you do. What is even going on anymore?
Not putting all of this at the end of the video.
That'll be the longest, most pointless ending ever.
People are like, I'm still listening to this? God damn.
Bioshock Infinite, you can buy it now on PS3.
You should Bioshock it. Or Rent-O-Shock it.
Or Borrow-Shock it.
But don't Torrent-Shock it.
I'm stopping my recording, by the way.